Everyone, it's Sevi, and I'm back with a video right before Hu Tao and Touma's banner drops in Genshin 2.2. With her first rerun coming up along with a new anticipated character, I feel like many Genshin Impact players are itching to finally throw all their Primo Gems at this banner. Of course, the announcement of Ito and Goro may have complicated things and questioned many a Hu Tao wanter who they wanted more, with some being on the fence and others wondering if they should continue saving their Primo Gems. So if you're set on pulling for Hu Tao, then I wish you all the best. But if you're still on the fence about her, then this video might help you decide. I'll be sharing what I think are the top reasons to pull for Hu Tao, and then some reasons why you might want to skip her instead. I just want to remind you that these are gameplay and content-based reasons, so if you're the type who pulls depending on character personality, I say follow your heart. Or listen to your wallet. Anyway, let's get started with reasons to pull. 1. She's a meta-defining pyro DPS character. Most Genshin players won't care about this, but even if you don't, it's somewhat nice to know you have a character that's considered as meta-defining. Even many updates later, Hu Tao still remains as one of the best carries that you can have on your team. If you've been struggling to clear content as an early or mid AR player, having Hu Tao on your team and building a team around her will be a long-term investment that can future-proof and carry you through the hardest content. She's a pyro character, so obviously she has access to the highest damage dealing reactions and comps out there, now and in the future. Even at C0, you won't feel like her power is unreasonably gated by her constellations. If you're getting Staff of Homa, then she'll be even more insane. However, Homa is not really required to start building her damage potential. If you're a free-to-play, you can work with White or Black Tassel or Prototype Star Glitter until you get something better. If you got Dragon's Bane from pulling, then that's already a best-in-slot 4-star for her. Or if you're a BP spender, then there's the Deathmatch. She also works well with 4-star supports. To start, you want Melt and Vaporize reaction comps. Kai is a unit that everyone has, and he's a starting point, even if, from my experience, it's a bit inconsistent to melt with Kaya. However, if you have Xing Chu, then you already have access to Hu Tao's most recommended team comp. 2. She has one of the most unique and well-made kits. I also personally think that Hu Tao has one of the most interesting mechanics we've seen among all the characters. The whole concept of needing low HP and being closer to a deathly state, which then empowers her, just meshes well with her overall lore and character qualities and works perfectly as a gameplay mechanic. To summarize, for those who aren't as familiar, as long as her HP is equal or below 50%, Hu Tao will get a further bonus to her pyro damage via her second passive talent. Her burst will also deal more damage and heal more HP that way. She does self-inflicted damage by activating her skill to help bring her faster into that half HP state. That's also why Hu Tao is busted on Staff of Homa, which gives an additional attack bonus if the user is below 50% HP. I personally find that the balancing act of keeping her safe despite being below 50% HP is a fun challenge to work with. If that sounds like the kind of thing you'd be willing to enjoy, then she's perfect for you. Not only is she an insane DPS, but she's a team player too. Hu Tao's first ascension passive gives all her teammates an extra 12% crit rate for 8 seconds after her pyro infusion skill ends. This really makes up for her DPS downtime and is a great kit addition for team synergy. 3. She has a new amazing artifact set, Shimanawa's Reminiscence. Now with the Inazuma region unlocked and new artifact sets added, she just received a modest power bump in the form of the 4-piece Shimanawa Reminiscence set. Before, her meta build was the 4-piece Crimson Witch of Flames for a reaction team. She could also work with a 4-piece Lava Walker for mono pyro teams, and both were already solid choices. I used to have 4-piece Crimson on my Hu Tao, but after farming for emblem pieces and getting a good Shimanawa set in the process, I've made the full switch to Shimanawa and have zero regrets. Since the way I play Hu Tao is less reliant on her burst and more on spamming her charged attacks, I find that 4-piece Shimanawa offers me more damage potential overall. Even with a reaction team comp, I find that my Shimanawa set, with a significant amount of EM stats, offered a noticeable bump in total damage compared to the Crimson Witch set. This isn't to say that you absolutely have to get Shimanawa over Crimson Witch artifacts. The Crimson set is still a top choice and can arguably be preferable if you run Hu Tao Tao exclusively on a reaction team, and your playstyle also relies on her burst. Even if she can't take full advantage of the 4-piece stacks, the Melt Vape damage bonus itself is already quite significant. But I'm also considering the value you get from the domain drops. 2-piece Shimanawa and 4-piece emblem sets are more universally usable than Crimson and Lava Walker artifacts. You can also hit 2 birds with 1 stone by farming in the Inazuma domain. Give the emblem pieces to your burst supports, and give the Shimanawa pieces to Hu Tao. You'll be laughing in HP rolls in no time. 4, Hu Tao will likely be awesome with Toma. Finally, the best reason is that you have a chance to get Toma on your Hu Tao banner pulls. My initial assessment is that Toma will make a fantastic shielder, hopefully second only to Zhongli. If you don't have Zhongli yet, Toma might be a very promising prospect to fill that role. If you're new to playing Hu Tao, it's almost essential to give her a shielder, especially in Spiral Abyss. Toma is an excellent candidate because aside from the tanky shield, he can also offer Pyro Resonance. Now, there may be a preliminary concern regarding Toma and reactions. Since Toma's ult creates cones of pyro when the on-field character does normal or charged attacks, there presents the possibility of him interfering with Hu Tao's vape or melt reactions. Thankfully, checking footage of those who stole Toma from his hangout, it looks like his pyro cones have a standard ICD. While for most pyro characters, an ICD isn't good news, this time it works in favor of Toma and Hu Tao's synergy. This means he won't be interfering significantly with Hu Tao's reactions. With that, you could get 2 awesome pyro characters in one banner who can work well together. It's the dream. Oh yeah, and she's the only one who makes suspicious dishes. Who wouldn't want the satisfaction of giving a suspicious dish to those NPCs' cooking quests? Hu Tao herself is such a good character that it's hard to think of reasons why you'd want to skip her. I wouldn't recommend myself to skip her. And if you're going to skip her, it won't be because she's bad. So here are my nitpicks for why she might be a skip for you. 1. You need to save her Ito and Goru. The most obvious reason would be skipping her for future characters, the most apparent ones being Ito and Goru. 2.3 seems to be a return to form for Geo after having experienced a drought of Geo characters for so long. Given that, it's interesting to see what the new tier characters and possible artifact sets have in store for the meta. If you don't have enough Primo Gems, ask yourself this. Are you willing to miss out on potentially getting 2 new defining Geo characters and exploring the new possibilities of Geo? Also, are you willing to miss out on Ito's magnificent sculpted abs? 2, you can start building Xiangling instead. Okay, what if, on one hand, you really want Hu Tao because you need a pyro DPS, yet on the other hand, you kind of want to use your primos on future characters? Thankfully, we already have a free pyro character that can deal an insane amount of damage with the right team comp. Amber. Xiangling! Alright, so Xiangling and Hu Tao are different characters with different playstyles and roles, obviously. But if all you're looking for is to fill in the role of a pyro unit that can vape and melt, Xiangling is right there. Do you have constellations on her? If you have her at C3 or C4, then congrats, she's already primed. Xiangling has the OG national team or Raiden national team going for her, and both teams are still very much capable of carrying you through Spiral Abyss. You might have those 4 stars already, or you will eventually get them, so farming for that might be a wiser choice to save your Primo Gems for another character. This could be the best compromise if you're desperate for a pyro unit but are trying to save your wallet. 3. You don't like cancelling animations and stamina management. To optimize Hu Tao's gameplay, you kind of have to learn how to animation cancel. Of course, it's not mandatory, you can totally choose not to, but you might eventually feel like you're missing out on damage. Hu Tao will prefer jump cancelling in particular since her charged attacks are very useful and require stamina management. Dash cancelling is also possible, but jump cancels are just more efficient in terms of stamina. So, if you don't like animation cancelling or micromanaging movement, you may not fully enjoy Hu Tao. Especially if you're playing on mobile, animation cancelling is not your friend. 4. You don't like her low HP based gameplay. Maybe for some, they prefer a safer and more comfortable way of playing. Maybe they rely on their healers and hate seeing characters with low HPs. If that's the case, it might be better to just wait for a Pyro that doesn't have this whole HP self-reduction mechanic. If you already have a good shielder like Zhongli or Diona or Toma eventually, then you'll be able to keep her safe in a certain HP range. But without those supports, Hu Tao may have a harder time. It's a perfectly valid reason. After all, we play Genshin to have fun, not get stressed out. And anyway, there are other Pyro units that you can build and who will do the job without Hu Tao's HP risks. 5. You already have too many Pyro characters. Look at your character list. You see all those unlocked Pyro characters? Maybe some of them are waiting to be built or improved. We have so many Pyros already, so be honest with yourself, do you really need another Pyro DPS? So that's going to be all for this video, everyone. Hu Tao has been such a long-awaited character with honestly so many benefits to her. I personally think it would be hard to pass her up on this rerun, but I want to hear what you think. If you're choosing to pull for her, what sealed the deal? And if not, what turned you away? Let me know in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to leave a like, consider subscribing to my channel for more Genshin Impact content, and turning on that notification bell button. I'll have some Toma content coming up, and I'll see you soon. Take care!